I just thought I'd do a quick video of this Grundig 2035. At the moment I've got a Grundig TK24 running through it, but the thing that makes this radio a bit more interesting than a normal 2035 is it comes with its remote control. So the remote control for this plugs in the back. You see that big plug there? The other silver one is for the tape recorder input. What you do when you plug this accessory into the back is you set the volume control to a reasonable level on the radio with a little bit more headroom than you'd need, a little bit more volume than you need. And then the volume control on this now so you can use that now for the volume control on the set, and then you have the different settings. So normally on the radio itself you only have tone controls, which you can see there. You've got bass and treble. You set those to maximum, and now you can use the sort of emphasis control on the remote and the ability to turn off the side speakers. Now in the manual for this itself it says if you want to listen to speech, it's sounds better with the 3D sound switched off, which is why they give it you the option on the remote here. You have quite a long lead, so you can sit quite some distance and get comfortable. These are different tone options, basically. So we'll go through them now and just to see if the phone will pick up a difference. The voice one basically cuts the bass. The solo boosts the sort of mid-range. The orchestra one seems to sort of increase the low end and increase the mid, but not so much the top, whereas the jazz really boosts the top end and the bass. But whether or not that will come across, we'll give it a try now. So turn the volume up. So I'll turn the 3D sound off and on so you can see if you can hear that difference. So that's off, that's on. To me, it adds a lot more sort of spacious sound to it because you can hear it coming from the sides of the radio. And now we'll, you can press a combination of however many of these buttons you like. So I've got these three pressed down. It tends to make it sound the best, but we'll go through one at a time now. So, as you can hear, voice just sort of kills the bass. Orchestra sort of boosts the bass in the mid and takes the top out. And then solo is very much the mid-range. And then jazz adds a lot of high-end. So we'll go through them again, back down. So turn that down a bit. And the radio set works. You've got off, pickup, long, medium, short, FM, and then you've got an aerial director. This turns the ferrite aerial round, and this turns that internal aerial on and off.
Ollie Samuels there, so, multitasking with an ice cream FM. In one hand and a microphone.
And again,
in the other.
So with just voice, you would press that.
Thank you for stepping forward.
And voice.
So there you go, we've had Colin the Caterpillar Gate. And now Percy Piggate, which you've heard there, has all but concluded.
And that does make it sound
Radio Shropshire,
really good.
On Tuesday morning.
It does make the voice sound a lot clearer, so I can understand why they gave the option to turn the 3D sound off and this voice control. It is a bit more pleasant to listen to the spoken word on the radio with it. This did give me a bit of a nightmare, to be honest, and I have to thank my friend Robert and John. Robert got me the circuit diagram from this, and my friend John helped me sort of fault find it. There was a couple of faults with it. The radio set itself was quite straightforward restoration. There was nothing really complicated about that, and it came with this, and it doesn't appear to have had an awful lot of use. But the Grundig Majestic Baton, as it's called, had an intermittent cable fault. When you wiggled the cable, it kept cutting in and out. Thankfully, the brake was at the plug end on the set, so I could just cut an inch off, and that cured that problem. And then there was a shorted resistor to one of the ground leads, so that killed the sound. So with the help of John, we diagnosed that and managed to push that out of the way. And there was a piece of metal shorting to ground, which I don't know how that happened, but yeah, that was another fault that was spotted. And then I managed to get it to work. So it's quite handy to be able to sit away from the set and control it. The actual handiest thing about the thing at all these days is the fact that when you've got radio adverts on, you don't have to get out of your chair to turn the volume down. You can just sort of mute the set, wait for the adverts to pass, and then carry on enjoying the radio program. So, yes, nice little accessory to have, and it's in very good condition. Just thought I'd show a video of it working, and for those people who may never have seen one, or at least heard one in action.